Hi students, welcome to the channel. In this video lecture, we will discuss the meaning of virtual machine provisioning. This video is related to virtualization in cloud computing. So before going to the main topic, I would like to tell you the meaning of virtual machine. Virtual machine is an virtual environment that functions as a virtual computer system with its own. It has its own CPU, memory, network interface card, and storage. Okay, it is created on physical hardware system that is mainly located off or on premises. Okay, here software is called hypervisor. Okay, and the hypervisor is separate. It is a separate machine resource from hardware and provisions them appropriately so that they can be used by any virtual machine. Okay, here the physical machines equipped with hypervisors such as KVM. KVM means kernels based virtual machines, right? It is also known as, its another name is host machine. We can also say it as host computer or simply host. Okay, there are many virtual machines that uses its resources are guest machines, guest computer. These are known as guest machines or guest computers, or we can say that guest operating systems, right? Or simply guest. The hypervisor treats computer resources like CPU. Memory and storage as a pool of resources that can be easily reallocated between existing guests or to new virtual machines. Right? Virtual machines are isolated. All the virtual machines are isolated from the rest of the system, and multiple virtual machines can exist on a single piece of hardware. Virtual machines, we can store any number of virtual machines inside them. Okay, they can be moved between host servers depending on demand or to use resources more efficiently. So this is all about virtual machine basic introduction. Now we will move further to the main topic, that is virtual machine provisioning. Virtual machine provisioning is done and explained with the help of virtual machine life cycle. In virtual machine life cycle, there are four phases. The first phase here is release. Okay, it include end of service, end of previous service. Okay, second point is compute resources deallocated to other systems, or we can say that other virtual machines. This is first step. Second step is IT service request. It include infrastructure requirement analysis and IT requests. If any of us want to request from cloud virtual machine, the IT requests are completed with the help of this step. Third one is virtual machine provision. Okay, this is our main topic, virtual machine provisioning. It is used to load operating system plus other appliances. It also customize and configure any kind of application. Next is start the server. द फोर्थ स्टेप इज वर्चुअल मशीन इन ऑपरेशन. द मेन फंक्शन ऑफ वर्चुअल मशीन इन ऑपरेशन इज दैट इट इज यूज्ड फॉर सर्विंग वेब रिक्वेस्ट एंड माइग्रेशन सर्विसेज. माइग्रेशन सर्विसेज, राइट. ऑल दीज आर द फोर फेजेज ऑफ वर्चुअल मशीन दैट आर यूज फॉर प्रोविजनिंग. एंड द मेन टॉपिक दैट इज वर्चुअल मशीन प्रोविजनिंग इज द थर्ड स्टेप ऑफ वर्चुअल मशीन लाइफ साइकिल, राइट. नाउ आई विल एक्सप्लेन द वर्चुअल मशीन लाइफ साइकिल इन डिटेल. इट स्टार्ट्स विद रिक्वेस्ट डिलीवर्ड टू आईटी डिपार्टमेंट. आईटी डिपार्टमेंट stating the requirement for creating a new server for a particular service, okay, and then this request is being processed by IT administrator to start seeing the server's resource pool. There is a server's resource pool, so many resources are there. It can be software resource, hardware resource, and any kind of resource, right. The server's resource pool matching these resources with the requirement and starting the provision. It will start provision to the needed virtual machine. To the needed virtual machine. Once it is provisioned and stated, it is ready to provide the required service. It is ready to provide required service according to an SLA. Okay, the next point is a time period after this, after all this, a time period occurs which the virtual machine is being released. Fourth step is released, and the fifth is free resources, right. All this is about the virtual machine life cycle. Next we will discuss virtual machine provision process. All these are some steps to provision virtual machine. First of all, you need to select a server from a pool of available services, like physical. It can be physical server with enough capacity. Along with the appropriate operating system template, you need to provision the virtual machine. You need to provision virtual machines. Secondly, you need to load the appropriate software including operating system you selected in the previous step. Device drivers, middleware, etc., and the needed applications for the service required. Thirdly, you need to customize. This is the second step. And thirdly, you need to customize and configure. You need to customize and configure the machine. For example, it include IP address and gateway, etc. This is the second step, okay. This is used to configure an associated network and storage resources. Finally, the virtual server is ready to start. It is installed and it is ready to start with its newly loaded software. So this is all about virtual machine provision process. I hope you like this video. Thank you so much for watching this.